The best news of 2022 has been leaked. We are getting a larger MacBook Air. Today, I want to tell you all the details about this new 15-inch MacBook with its specs, design, and of course, the MacBook Air 15-inch release date and price. But first, a bit of background knowledge of the MacBook Air. The MacBook Air was first announced in 2008 with Steve Jobs showing off the first generation. What made this notebook or laptop or MacBook unique was its form factor, and essentially it kicked off the Ultrabook era for the last 12 years or so. Steve Jobs showed this small form factor by just pulling the MacBook Air out of a brown paper envelope to show how small and thin it really was. The screen size was, and is still today, a 13-inch display. The design wasn't perfect and caused some technical issues, but since then we've had an updated design in 2010 where the MacBook Air really took hold, with a lot of users realizing if you just wanted a MacBook for everyday tasks, then this was the model to buy. Apple introduced an 11-inch model as well at this time. In 2018 though, we got the third generation MacBook Air, what added such features like a Retina display, Touch ID, and an even thinner design, but the 11-inch model was gone. Then in 2020, the Apple M1 silicon chipset was added to the MacBook Air and was the first MacBook Air to be fanless, and still remains today as the only MacBook to be like this inside the current lineup. So now, in 2022, we've been told that a larger 15-inch MacBook Air is now on its way for the first time ever, and it's really exciting to hear this. We've had a report from Ross Young, who has said a supplier of Apple screens is creating some 15-inch LED screens. The reason why this is interesting and exciting is that currently the only MacBook screens made with a 13-inch Retina display and have an LED screen option is just for the MacBook Air and the Pro. But we do have that newer display now, the mini LED display, being used in the light of the MacBook Pro 14-inch and 16-inch model. We do also have a 12.9-inch display of mini LED in the iPad Pro, but Apple, as of this moment, create no products that uses just a standard 15-inch LED display instead of using mini LED. This means that Apple are making a new MacBook, and it's quite guaranteed that it is the new MacBook Air with a larger display. At the moment, the name for this MacBook Air hasn't really been secured, if it will be called the MacBook Air with a 15-inch display, or another name like the MacBook Air Max. But with any of these leaks, even up to the new MacBook Air's release date that I find and show you guys, a lot of previous leaks for other Apple products have come true, but there are sometimes some that get misinterpreted based on the facts that leakers have been told. I can only present to you what I have been told and shown. No leak or rumor is 100% true until we see the final MacBook Air being officially shown from Apple. However, if you are like me and if you are watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what the next generation MacBook Air is going to be like and want to know what the latest leaks and rumors are, no matter what they tell us. So, just quickly guys, recently this channel got over 300,000 subscribers, what is absolutely amazing. So in celebration of this, I've decided to do a giveaway of this. It is an iPhone 13 Pro Max, and it is in white silver, and it's a 256GB model option. So recently I've given away a Sierra Blue one when we got over 300,000 subscribers, and I'm going to be giving away this iPhone 13 Pro Max when we get over 350,000 subscribers. And all you need to do to enter into this international giveaway is just write down in the comments below of what Apple gear you're planning to buy in 2022. Write it down in the comments below, and also at the same time as well, make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because I'll be revealing who the winner is when we get over 350,000 subscribers via a video, and you won't want to miss that notification for that video. Now quickly, I just want to mention as well, sadly there are a lot of scammers and spammers out there who use my face, for example, and also tell you to WhatsApp them. This is not me, and I'm afraid they're not giving away any giveaways out there. I'm the only one who's doing the giveaway, and you can make sure it's me by seeing that there's a tick next to my actual name, and also, like I said, that any comments or anything will have that tick, but the actual giveaway itself will be on that actual video when we get over 350,000 subscribers, not before. Well, with that out of the way, let's return back to the video. So, release day. As we've now had the March event called Peak Performance, what focused mainly on the Mac Studio, on the Mac side of things, obviously we did have the iPhone SE and the new iPad Air, this means the next event is WWDC. But at this event, we're expecting to see the new Mac Pro, and maybe talks about the M2 generation, what will be put into Macs throughout the next 2 years. With that, it's expected the MacBook Air will probably be one of the first devices to actually get one of the M2 chipsets inside it, and it's most likely it'll be coming out for this year in October or November time, as by this point the M1 MacBook Air will be approaching 2 years old and could do with a wanted upgrade. However, we've had a report saying that the larger MacBook Air is coming out in 2023. If this is the case, at the moment it's likely it'll be coming out at a March or April event in 2023, and it'll probably be the star of that event. For the official date of that event, or when the MacBook Air Max will be in our hands, it's too early to say at this point when that's going to be, but it's most likely it is pointing towards the early part of 2023. But moving on, let's do a summary of what the MacBook Air Max is going to give us and the prices. So this new MacBook Air Max, that's what I'm going to call it now, or the MacBook Air 15-inch with an M2 chipset inside it, it's going to come with a 15.4 LED Retina display, and this is the main star of this MacBook Air, is its actual large display. It's going to be a resolution of 2880 by 1800, and this is actually the same size screen of what we used to get in the old 15.4 MacBook Pros, and essentially is a very, very similar display to that. Now, right away, the first thing you might have noticed, it's not a ProMotion display, so it does not mean it has an adaptive refresh rate. This is not going to be inside the new MacBook Air. It's going to be a standard 60 Hz panel inside it, very similar to what we had with the MacBook Air M1 and like the likes of, say, the 13-inch MacBook Pro as well. So basically, no big changes there, just a normal LED Retina display inside this MacBook Air M2. For storage, it is likely it's going to be very similar to what we have right now. So 256GB, 512, 1TB and 2TB storage options. There will be that brand new M2 chipset inside it, and it is likely, according to the latest leaks, what I will cover more in other videos, to be an 8-core CPU and also a 10-core GPU at the moment. There will also be the option again of 8GB or 16GB of RAM to pick for your MacBook Air. The actual design is going to be a completely new design, as you can see here. It's likely it's going to be a little bit more thinner than the MacBook Air we have right now, but we're also going to be getting colors as a first, according to some of the latest leaks and rumors. But it will be made out of aluminium, and there will still be two USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports on one side, and also those Thunderbolt 4 ports will be also compatible with USB 4. The new design, what I just spoke about, the new colors ranges that are coming out for it will be blue, green, red, silver, yellow, orange, and purple, what are the exact same colors that we got with the iMac M1. It's also likely we've been told that there's going to be a center stage webcam in the middle of the new MacBook Air, what will be a 12 megapixel camera. But moving on to the actual battery life, it's expected with the M2 chipset to get up to around about 20 hours of battery life out of this larger MacBook Air. And then moving on to price then, so we're just getting a standard M2 chipset and 8GB of RAM inside it. A 256GB model will start at $1,199, then 512GB at $1,349, and then 1TB, $1,699, and then a 2TB option at $2,049. Now, obviously, all these specs that I've just shown you here are based on what we know at the moment. This could change in the future. But next, for my wishes for the MacBook Air. My wish is to do with the colors. So we've seen some great colors in the comp sets and renders that you're looking at right here. But also there are some rumors and leaks to say that the new MacBook Air is going to have all these multiple different colors that are going to be very similar to the iMac and the iPad Air, for example. However, I would like to still have the ability to buy a silver, a gold, or a space gray MacBook Air like we can right now. But those are my thoughts and my current wish for the MacBook Air. However, let me know your thoughts if you agree with having this kind of choice or not. Also, at the same time, write in the comments what your wishes would be for the new MacBook Air in 2022. Well guys, it's time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you soon. Bye.